the work of God, if you encounter some obstacles, difficulties, or dangers, this is what it meant. Ask in my name, and the Father will give you. This is not ask for a Ferrari, or ask for a mansion, or ask for the lottery, or ask for whatever your personal desires. This is not what it meant. While you're doing the work of God that He has set before you, He knows there will be obstacle, and in order to overcome that obstacle, you know, you have to pray.
Amen.
And Father will help you out, will give you a way. That's what it meant. But a lot of people, you know, they twist the verses here and there. You see it very, very often. I see it too much already. They twist it in order to draw people. You know, if you claim it, you speak it, you'll have it. You know, Christian life is not as easy as it sounds, that's what they say, right? But all I know that even through these difficulties, God will never leave us.
Amen.
That's the only thing. I chose you and appointed you so you can ask anything you want? No. There is a requirement, conditions for prayer. If you ask in my name, that is based on His will. But a lot of people, you know, twist the word of God in order to draw people. I was listening this afternoon in a certain conference, like, you know, a lot of people now, they try to set up the church in order to draw people to the church, right? Somebody criticized a certain church and said, "Oh, the church is too boring. The church is, I don't feel like listening. It's boring. Like, you know, I cannot sit there for 2 hours or 1 hour." Okay, we make it short. Oh, this is too much complaint. So then, okay, in order to cater all these people, okay, we'll put daycare, we'll put gym, we'll put everything, right, in order to draw the people. But we miss the point. You know, it is not us who draw people to Himself. It is God who draws people to Himself. Right? It is not all these plans, all these things, you know. You know that draws people to the church? Preaching the Word of God.
Amen.
Simple. Yes. You preach the Word of God, you live through the Word of God, it is God who will bring the people.
Amen.
Okay? Not you and me. I may drag somebody here, they will be here for because they are, you know, giving me a favor. Oh, I feel sorry for Father Louis, I will go there one time. No. Next week is not going to be there. So, if you want God to bring the people in the church, you preach the word. If you have to run somebody on the ground, well, not take it literally, I mean. Because sometimes, you know, sometimes people compromise. Because, you know, oh, I don't want to speak this because there's somebody in the church. Oh, I don't want to speak this because it might hurt somebody. That's what I mean. If you have to run them. You have to speak the truth. Because if you, you know, pamper them like babies, they will not grow. You have to tell the truth. With love, of course. Right? You don't target. Oh, because this guy I know. What verse? You don't do that. Right? So I was speaking one time, I said I might offend somebody, and I believe I may have offended somebody, but it's not intentional. It's not intentional. Sometimes I would rather go to a church where I don't know the situation, so I can, you know, I can speak free. But when I know that there's something happening there and I go there, sometimes, you know, you have the tendency, do I have to speak this topic because I know they have a problem there like this? Or do I avoid it? Or do I do it? What would I do? Sometimes it's So difficult, right? But of course, we know the choice. You have to skip the pulpit in love. You don't use the pulpit to target somebody. No, never do that, please. Okay? You remain in me, and my words remain in you. Whatever you wish, it will be done for you. That's what God promised, for the glory of God. Now you might say, I don't have any qualifications. Then we don't need to go back to the original apostles. You might say, I don't know the Bible. I didn't go to seminary school. I myself also did not go to seminary school. I was educated in the Middle East in regards to the Word of God. None of our 13 pastors went to Bible school. None. But the church is growing. Church is being blessed. In a place where you could not worship freely. And the irony is, when we are in a free country, where are the people? Right? There we have to lower the volume in order to sing. Here you can sing as loud as you want. And sometimes, you know, it's like, you know, the a Tristan. In the Philippines, they call it Tuod. Tristan, you know. There is worshiping, I mean, and there is praising. Are you glad to be here, or are you glad, or just because somebody invited you? Approach God with thanksgiving, right? With joy, with praises. And, you know, here it's too long, this pastor speaking too much, right? But God works in our life. Do not estimate what God can do with your life. It doesn't matter. You are uneducated. You have no talent. You have no skills. The more you need to just yield to the hands of God like a clay. Remember Psalm 37 verse 4? Delight yourself in the Lord and He will give the desires of your heart. And some people use it, you know, I desire to be rich. I desire to be this, to be that. But they forgot that the meaning of the verse delight means pliable. Means like, you know, a clay that can be shaped whatever the potter desires. So if you make yourself like a clay that is pliable, that can be molded according to the desire of the potter, you ask whatever and God will provide the desires of your heart. Because your desire is to please God.
Amen.
Amen?
Yes.
Amen. And there is a promise here in Philippians chapter 2, verse 13. For it's God who works in you to will and to act in order to fulfill His good purpose. He is the one who is working in you, in me, to will and to act. To carry it into completion. That's why we have this song. I know Him, I believe it, and I am persuaded that He is able to keep what He had promised. Until that day, the day of Christ. Which brings us back to John 21, verse 15. The same question. Do you love me more than this? What is our priority? What is on the top of our list? And Peter said, yes, no, Lord, I know you love, you know, I love you. Our obedience to God is tied up with how much we love Him. If we love Him, according to Him, He said, then obey my commandments. You may not be equipped, but God will equip you. All you need to do is to yield to the will of God. Let us pray. Father God in heaven, we thank you for this time that you have given us. We pray, O Lord, that you continue to mold us according to your image. We pray, O Lord God, that we may glorify you in the life that you have given us. We pray, O Lord God, that you give us the courage to speak up in regards to our faith. We pray, God, the Lord God, that you bless this church. Continue to draw people to yourself. This I pray in Jesus' name.